kinds of water. Today we are going to learn about condensation. This we have only learned in the fifth and sixth standard. In fifth and fourth standard books you have come across this word. What do you mean by condensation? Before that, I'll ask you a question. What do you mean by evaporation? You have read the lesson before? Yes or no? So I hope you will come to know what you mean by evaporation. So can you tell me, children? Yes, evaporation means the water is converted into water vapor. Then it is called as evaporation. Now today we will learn what you mean by condensation. When this water vapor, now from water into water vapor. Now when water vapor is converted into water. What children? The water vapor is converted into water. Then it is called as condensation. What do you call it as children? Condensation. So let us see how the water vapor is converted into water. It is very common experience that on cold winter mornings, when we speak, we observe smoke like vapor coming out of our mouths. Why does smoke like vapor come out of our mouth in winter? Do we experience this in summer? It normally happens. We go to a nearby store. Sometimes people usually do this in the DMarts and all. There is a gas. Okay? So when they open the mouth, they'll just blow them. So when you blow it, there is a vapor type of formation which is covering like a fog, like a smoke type. Right? It's covered. On that again you will write your name. It usually happens, yes? So why does the smoke like vapor comes out from our mouth? In winter, the air in our atmosphere is very cool as compared to the air coming out from our mouth. Water vapor present in the air coming out from our mouth gets cooled suddenly to form very tiny droplets. These tiny droplets concentrated in a limited area after they appear like a smoke or a small cloud near our mouth. So what he's telling is, during winter season, usually the climate will be very, very cold. So what he's telling, when you open your mouth and blow the air suddenly, so what all the droplets which is present in that particular area will come closer to it and it forms like a cloud-like structure. That's why we can see a fog or something, smoke that is formed and we are able to see that actually. Okay, that's really great, children. And he has given an activity to perform. What he is doing is taking a glass which is filled with water and he is adding some ice cubes. What he is adding is adding some ice cubes. You normally can observe in your house also, not only this glass, normal glass you take, fill it up with the normal ice cubes also. You can fill it up with the gentle water. So what you can see? Outside of the glass, you can see a small droplets of water coming out. Yes or not? Usually you can observe. If you want, you are listening to me now, right? So open your fridge, take a glass of water, put the ice cubes in it, and check whether the water droplets are coming out of your mouth. Okay, children? So water comes, ice cold water in the glass cools its surface. So while it is doing it, the ice which is inside the water cools its surface itself. Air around the glass contains water vapor which is warmer than the surface of the water which is inside. So due to the cold glass, air close to its surface will also become cooler. This changes the water in the air around the surface of the glass into water and forms small droplets on the outer surface of the glass. Have you ever observed in your daily life where water vapor changes into the water? As I just told you, you can just go to the fridge, open the fridge, take a glass of water, add the ice cubes into it, and check whether the water droplets are coming out of the glass or not. Now, next, the clouds and water converts into the water vapor by the process of evaporation. So we have already learned what you mean by evaporation. So evaporation is what water, the water is inside the sea, oceans, lakes, it gets evaporated by the sun. It heats it and it is again it is mixing up in the air. After the cloud it structures from through the we get the air. So this process, what process? First of all, see this process. This is sun here and we have a lake here and this is mountains here. We have clouds which is formed and let us have a small house like thing. So what is the sun doing? What the sun doing? He is taking water. That's he is taking the water. Again, from water it is evaporating into the air. Then it is forming the clouds. After forming clouds, there is a after forming clouds, what he is doing? From clouds we get the rains. Yes or not? First evaporation process, then clouds, then rain. So this process we call it as water cycle. What we call it? We call it as the water cycle. The process of converting the water into the rain. Similar, the water evaporate, mixed in the air, clouds are formed, again from cloud to rain, so water to water. So this process is called as a water cycle. So next, clouds in the kitchen, take a vessel filled with water, keep it in on the slab and heat it slowly. Observe for some time, now cover the vessel with a plate, remove the plate after some time. Do you see any changes on the inner surface of the plate? Pour some cool water in the plate and observe what happens. What similarities do you find between evaporation of water from surface of the water bodies and evaporation of water from the bowl heated in the kitchen? Both the cases discussed above, we know that water vapor helps to form the clouds. Yes. Similarly, at home you're there, take a bowl of water, close the lid, heat it for some time. So after heating it, boil it, heat it for some time. After some time, switch it off, open the lid. You can see the smoke-like structures coming up. Yes, that is evaporation. But after the lid which you open, you can see at the back of the water, there's a small droplets of water. That is formed as a clouds. Yes or not? Even this process, the process which we did at home, through the water converting into clouds again, with the droplets. So that and this is the same as we have the water cycle. Okay? Children, I hope you understood very well what do you mean by condensation now and what is a water cycle. Why it is called as a water cycle? Okay, children? So in the next class, we will go further information.